You sinner! You need to accept him, or you're gonna burn in hell forever.
This is not the way to do it. When you're presenting the gospel, you need to do it with love.
Hi. Hello. Do you know about Jesus? Well, let me tell you about him.
Another thing to consider is when you share the gospel.
Really? What can I share with him? Now? Okay, I'll do it.
You should be sharing the gospel as the Spirit leads. You also need to consider who you share it with, people who are willing to hear.
Hi, can I talk to you about Jesus? Well, Jesus, we're all sinners, and Jesus came to save us. And...
Hold on.
Sometimes they won't want to hear it.
I don't care about this. I don't want them to hear about it.
But...
Let them go. We can't force anyone to listen and accept the gospel.
Without a doubt, you will face prison.
Look at that. It's a Christian. Look at that. Look at her. She's so weird.
Her rocking hair looks ball. Like a horse's tail. Jesus freak.
Why am I even doing this? Why do I have to go through this?
I know.
It's not fair.
In James, we are called to consider it pure joy whenever we face trials, because perseverance leads to maturity. And why do we share the gospel? It's something Jesus told us to do in the Great Commission in Matthew 28:16-20.
Why do I need God?
Well, without God, there's no salvation. Anyone who rejects him can't go to heaven, and they spend eternity.
Can't the good things I do outweigh the bad?
Well, no, they can't. Romans 6:23 says that the wages of sin is death. Any sin we commit is punishable by death, no matter how much good we've done.
How does loving God send people to hell?
Really, God doesn't send people to hell. It's their actions that do. We all really deserve hell. But since God is a loving God, he provides a way for us to not have to go to hell. Well, it's really ABC. Accept that Jesus died on the cross, believe that his sacrifice is enough to pay for your sins, and confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord.
Is it possible for me to lose my salvation?
No. In Ephesians, it says that when we accept the Holy Spirit, he's our guarantee for heaven, and we can't lose him.
Has God ordained everything we do, or do we have choices?
Sometimes, they'll ask questions that you won't know the answer to. There are two ways you can answer these. You could say,
well, I don't really know the answer, but I can go ask like a pastor or somebody who might know and get back to them.
Or you might need to say,
well, believing in Jesus is based on faith. And sometimes there are things that we don't know the answer to, and we won't know until we get to heaven. So really, in the meantime, we just have to wait and trust that God knows what he's doing.
Never pretend you know the answer.
Well, you know, God just predestines everything.
What about choices?
Well, he predestines the choices that we have and then what we choose.
Freeze. You'll look pretty foolish. She's alone. Always be prepared to share the gospel. Opportunities will come up when you least expect them.
Hey, Sarah. I've been feeling pretty awful lately. And I noticed that you're different. Can you tell me why?
Well, it's because I have Jesus.
Well, can you tell me about it?
Can you just wait a minute? I have to look something up, okay? Okay. Just wait here.
Angela, I've been feeling pretty awful lately, and I noticed that you're different. Can you tell me why?
Well, it's because I have Jesus in my heart.
Can you tell me about him?
Sure. In the book of Romans, it outlines it really simply in what the church likes to call the Romans Road. It starts in chapter 3, verse 23. For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. We've all sinned, and no matter what we've done to sin, it separates us from God. In Romans 6:23, it says, for the wages of sin is death. We all should die for our sins. And it's not like, oh, I died in a car accident, or I got old and died. It's like, death, like eternal separation from God in hell, like the lake of fire. It's awful. But the end of this verse says, but the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. God gives us eternal life as a gift, and we can accept it from Him, and like it's a way out of hell. The next verse is verse 8, chapter 5. It says, but God demonstrates His own love for us in this. While we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Jesus gave up His life so we could spend eternity with God. It's pretty awesome.
That's kind of morbid. I mean, He died.
Oh, but He didn't stay dead, though. He rose from the dead after 3 days, and now He lives in heaven. And He lives in us if we want Him to.
I want Him to live in me.
Okay, well, going on with the road, in chapter 10, verse 13, it says, for everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. And then in verses 9 through 10, it says that if you confess with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised Him from the dead, you will be saved. For it is with your heart that you believe and are justified. It is with your mouth that you confess and are saved. So if you wanted to, I could pray with you right now so you could have Him in your heart.
Yeah, I'd like that.
Okay, so what you need to do is pray and ask God for forgiveness for your sins. Ask Jesus to come into your heart and ask God to make you a new person.
God, I want you to forgive me of all the sins I've done. And I want Jesus to come into my heart and make me a new person. In Jesus' name.
Welcome to the family, Daniel. Sarah, guess what? I just shared the gospel with someone and they accepted Jesus.
That's awesome!
I know, it's so cool. And it was all because I was prepared and ready to share it. Are you prepared?